we're here with Rich Mckain from Real Effects as an animation supervisor. Mm-hmm. So we were just talking a little bit about your background, where you're from. You're from Canada, Calgary.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So that's
Yeah, where you I grew up in Calgary, Alberta. I feel like I was one of those lucky people who realized early on what they wanted to do.
That's great.
I was in grade 11, not 11th grade, we call it grade 11 up there. And Toy Story 1 had come out, and it was one of those things where it was like, that's what I want to do. I don't know how or why, but that's what I want to do.
Right.
And so ever since then, I was trying to get to that mm-hmm. spot. Then it was like how everybody is coming out of school. It's like, all right, I have no experience, so I can't get a job. Don't have a job because I can't get any experience. Mm-hmm. So SIGGRAPH was going on that summer when I was graduating, and that was in Florida. So I convinced a couple of us to go down there with mm-hmm. our demo reels in hand, just to try to get some feedback. I thought that was the hardest thing to do, is get that industry feedback. It's like, I know I'm not good enough, just tell me why and I'll go and fix that. Mm-hmm. Oh, tell me what I need to work on. Mm-hmm. So I got lucky, and there's a couple of people. There's a girl, I wish I would have wrote down her name, who worked on Titanic. And she had sat me down and went through my demo reel a couple times and,
oh, wow.
and gave me all these notes. And there's another guy in another school who gave me notes. So then I spent the next 6 months working on my demo reel. And I applied at 100 different places. So I sent out 100 of those over those 6 months, and I got one job offer. And that was for a video game company in Salt Lake City, mm-hmm. Utah. So I took it. And that was just like a springboard, a stepping stone to throughout my career. So I was there for a year and a half, then went to Lucas Learning in San Francisco for a year. Then I went to Oddworld for 4 years. And then it was, I thought video games would be like, for me, it was like we all have our own sort of paths and goals. Mm-hmm. For me, it was film, and specifically Pixar at the time. Mm-hmm. So I thought, 2 years in games, that'll be my stepping stone into Pixar, no mm-hmm. problem, right? Mm-hmm. How naive of me. Finally, I got some job offers for film, but it still wasn't Pixar, and I ended up going to Blue Sky. So I worked on Ice Age 2, Horton Hears a Who, and Ice Age 3, and then finally, with that experience, I got the call from Pixar, and so worked on Up, Toy Story 3, Cars 2, and Brave. Mm-hmm. And then how I got to Dallas was the director I worked with on Horton Hears a Who, Jimmy Hayward, he called me up and said, hey man, I'm doing this film in Dallas, you want to come supervise? And I'm like, where the hell is Dallas? And then it was like, then I heard more about it and heard more about the studio, came and visited. It's like, yeah, I'm mm-hmm. in. I'm in.
So you're here to talk about Free Birds, which
yep.
is coming out November 1st.
Yep, so our movie's called Free Birds. It's about two turkeys who discover a time machine in a secret government lab and decide to go back to the first Thanksgiving in order to get turkeys off the menu.
Oh, funny.
And so it's voiced by Owen Wilson, Woody mm-hmm. Harrelson, and Amy Poehler. Mm-hmm. It'll be 2 years for me that I was on the show mm-hmm. when it comes out in 2 weeks. And yeah, it's a buddy comedy. It's a lot of fun. And it's for kids of all ages.
Yeah, great.
Yeah, and we're really proud of it. We worked pretty hard on it. It's the 20th anniversary mm-hmm. For Real Effects, mm-hmm. and you know they started in 1993 with two guys in a garage, mm-hmm. and now it's over 400 employees.
Y'all are over 400 employees.
Yeah.
Are you the biggest studio in Texas? You'd have to be.
I don't know.
You'd have to be.
It must be.
Yeah.
Wow, I never thought about it mm-hmm. like that. Wow.
Yeah.
I'm sitting up straight now.
Yeah. So
yeah.
You're huge.
And what one of the things that drew me to Real Effects and to Texas was the chance of this new animation studio being born. And mm-hmm. it doesn't happen very often. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we'll wait and see. Hopefully the world likes
yeah.
it.
I think that they're gonna love it. Absolutely. So if you had some advice for students coming into the industry, what would that be?
I think if you truly believe it, then you should never give up. That mm-hmm. was my thing. Like, I wasn't born with some artistic talent. Both my parents are accountants, so I didn't get much on the artistic
yeah.
side from them. But they always believed in me, and mm-hmm. no matter how crazy it was. And when I got out of school, like I was saying, like I kept applying. I kept all those notes that I got from those artists at SIGGRAPH, mm-hmm. I spent that 6 months working mm-hmm. basically full-time mm-hmm. doing a new short film and working on those notes mm-hmm. and that sort of thing. So I was always just trying to improve, improve, mm-hmm. improve. Mm-hmm. And like, I mean, you hear it before, but never stop learning. Mm-hmm. With every games company I worked at, was also working on stuff on the side just to try to get to that next level. I always had that goal in mind, so that might be a piece of advice. If you know if you know what you want to do, just always keep thinking about it.
Stay focused.
And believe in it. Yeah.
Absolutely. Well, thank you for coming by today. I appreciate it.
Thanks. Thanks for having me.